jumping iron.
Day 314. We did it this morning. It was back at deadlifts. Deadlifts are all just not that good. My form is just so bad. Like, I just videoed everyone, and I know when it's pulling me over. Like, the weight's pulling me over, which is, like, the worst thing in deadlifts. So I need to focus on cutting slack. I did practice with, like, 225 lighter weight. Because I used to have good form. This one guy taught me. His name is Andrew. He was deadlifting, like, 650. Yeah, I need to get that form back because deadlift is so technical. Like, one little small movement and little change can completely change how much weight you're really lifting. It's all about leverage. Yeah, right? So, you know, if you're being pulled over and the weight's like pulling you forward, it just makes it so much harder and so much more work you have to do to actually get the weight off the ground. Compared to, you know, bench press, you still use leverage, right? Because you're pushing against something, right? And you can decrease range of motion, but it's still like the same pressing movement, right? But with deadlifts, you're kind of hinging. And then, you know, it's like you can do like half deadlifts, or if you've ever done like shrugs, like just deadlifting, like rack pulls is what I'm saying. It's just a different type of leverage when you do a rack pull, because you could do probably a lot more than your deadlift, right? Obviously, it is a shorter range of motion, but it's also different leverages. Right, because once you have the weight already up, then you're kind of just standing up, right? And that's different than like a bench press, right? Once the weight, I mean, you're just pushing the entire time, but leverage, it's you're pushing, but you're also hinging, so it's like a different motion. Same like compared to squat, same thing with squat is like a bench press, but you're just pushing the floor away. Bench press, you're pushing the bar away, and then deadlifts, you can think like you're pushing the floor away, but it's more of like a hinge movement. And maybe I'm wrong, I'm not a deadlift expert, so. Just gotta figure that out. But the back was good, and then I threw in a lot of shoulders. My shoulders hadn't been that sore in a while, and I think it's working, so I think I'm getting bigger shoulders. What else? Yeah, and then I'm gonna do biceps tonight probably, just because I have free time and classes really haven't, they've started, but syllabus week, all that stuff, you know, not too hard right now, but it'll probably get a little bit harder. I think I'm only gonna do 5 classes though. But still 18 credits, so tried to find the way to get the most credits for the easiest with the less time and minimal effort, which is the goal. But obviously we're still taking some cool classes. I'm taking a philosophy class, which will be fun. I think I'll love my accounting class just because I loved the last accounting class. And then I have like this business organization class, which is kind of stupid, but and then one of my favorites might actually be like advanced business finance, which is just kind of dealing with financial terms, which will be good for what I want to do with banking. So that's the plan. I weighed 190 this morning, which is kind of funny. Ate a lot of chicken last night. We had a Canes Rush event, but now I pretty much did not eat all day. So I didn't eat in the morning. I had like a little bit of cereal, just drank water. I didn't feel hungry. She needs the bathroom, get it all out of me. but yeah, just gotta keep the weight under control a little bit, you know. Don't wanna eat too much, gain too much weight too quickly, because then it's all fat. But yeah, we're doing well now, so just gonna hit more arms, gonna get the biceps big, and spam curls. And we got chest tomorrow, which is my favorite day by far. I'm so excited. Compared that to, I mean, I'm fairly excited for leg days, but I think now, like, I just don't like my back days because of deadlifts. But once I start, you know, I know I can reach a level where I can PR every single session on deadlifts. I know there's like a groove I'll find for a month, and then it'll just be really fun. That's what happens with squat usually. I'll hate it for a little bit and be like, fuck, why am I doing squats? And then you'll be hitting a PR every session, you'll just be grooving, you'll just be excited. That's how I feel about bench right now. Obviously not hitting a PR every session, but I'm just so excited to bench because I want to hit my goals, you know. And I do have goals for squat and deadlifts, but not compared to, like, that's all I want. It's 4 or 5 bench. So still a lot of work obviously I don't even think I could hit 315 right now, you know? Same thing with all my other lifts, you know, very, very far away. And I said this in another video, you know, I'm doing it because it's hard, not because it's easy. If I wanted what was easy, I would have just done 365. And still, that's pretty hard. But I'm pretty much set an impossible goal, especially at the time frame. See, that's a good point. You know, I think most goals are achievable, but what makes them impossible is the time frame. Because, you know, the goals have to be, there has to be a time aspect, or it's just a random thought, you know, it's just an idea. It's just a hope, it's a dream. But if you put time to it and you put action to it, then it becomes a goal, like you're actually working towards it. You know, some people dream of being rich and whatever, but it doesn't become a goal until you set a time to it. I want to have it and set how much money you want and how, what are you going to do to get there, and then it's a goal. If you're just hoping, you know, say it's your goal, it's not really your goal. You got to write it down, write how you're going to get there, write how long it's going to take, and write what you're going to do every day. You'll probably maybe get there, maybe not. I didn't do all those things from 405, but I kind of know what I'm going to do, you know. I know the time frame. It's by the end of this year, which is short, so that's going to be hard. I know what I'm going to do. Like, I already work out every day. Obviously, I had to switch some things up, so, you know, different training stuff, maybe diet, but we're working towards it, and tomorrow will be fun. And I finally got the dip thing, so I'm about to, that's what I'm excited for. It's just blowing up my dip. Like, if I can get to 4 plates on dips, 4 or 5 plates, wow. We'll be moving some big weight, so that's the goal. Gotta take it slowly, though. And that's why patience is the number one. Well, patience is a virtue, or whatever they say, but it's important. Especially with, you know, a lot of things that are bad in life are simply because you don't want to wait. Or you do things because, I mean, it's the short, you know, road. It's the easy road, you know. But it pays dividends to take the long road sometimes. So, yep, I'll see you on the next one.